Isabella's POV. Let's go home now. My legs are screaming and yelling at me to stop. Please. I yelled out to the three devils in disguise, to which they only laughed. Right now we are in the mall looking for a suitable gift for Nate and costumes for ourselves. The party is in 2 days and everyone is excited for their beta's birthday. I bought a charming shirt for him that says, "I don't wake up to impress you," and a pair of Oakley shades. Nina got him new Vans because apparently his shoes smell. Cole bought a couple necklaces so that when he finds his mate, he can give it to her. And as for Cameron, she is giving him a new watch. As we were searching for our outfits, I felt someone's hand on my shoulder. The touch burned me. I flinched and turned around. A guy was standing behind me, now facing me with a smile on his face. The girls were too engrossed in shopping to notice. "Who are you? And how dare you touch me?" I almost growled. No one can touch me besides Damien. His smile didn't falter, and he kept staring at me.
"Hi, my name is Benson, but you can call me Ben."
He extended his hand for me to shake. I don't want to be burned again, so I just glared at him. He chuckled and dropped his hand to his side. "I'll ask again. Who are you, and why are you talking to me?" He didn't answer, but looked me up and down. I felt disgusted under his stare, but didn't lose my cool. His eyes landed on my neck, and his eyes darkened. They reflected pure anger.
"You have a mate,"
he stated. I just nodded, but from the inside I was breaking my head from the amount of confusion. He took a few deep breaths, and his eyes changed back to its normal dull blue.
"Soon enough, sweetheart. We will meet again, soon, and when we do, situations will be different,"
he said while stepping back, and then took off. I was standing there like a fool. I shook my head and decided to mind-link Damien to fix my sour mood. "Damien!"
"Yes, baby? You done all the shopping?"
he said in a happy voice. He always makes me feel better. "No, not yet. We got the gifts, but the outfit is still not decided."
"Oh, can I suggest something?"
"Of course."
"Dress like a princess. You know, like Disney princesses."
"Why? Is there a specific reason for it?"
"Yep. I'll be dressing as a prince, so we'll match."